Okay, students, we are going to have a session on GATE questions discussion. So this is mainly for the upgradation of your core subject architecture, that is computer architecture. In this session, we are going to discuss about the memory technology. So memory technology plays a very important role in any kind of system management and data management. So in this session, we are deeply going to have a discussion on cache memory in depth. Okay, so there are many kinds of memory management, out of which we are going to see about cache memory and the related topics to that. So there are many GATE questions which are mainly focuses on cache memory and its various aspects. So this session is mainly concentrated on cache memory and its various consequences. Okay, so these are all the basic discussions that we have to made regarding this cache memory. We already know that cache memory is a fastest memory, and it is a very important memory for fast access of data from the computer. Okay, so there are many different aspects regarding cache memory. Okay, so based on the performance of how the memory or the files which are there in the cache memory is accessed, regarding that there are many performance computations. So here we are seeing the concept called a cache hit and a cache miss. Okay, so cache hit, first we will see what is cache hit. Okay, so cache memory we already know, whenever we are in access of we are in need of any frequently needed kind of information or files, then the computer will put that in the special kind of memory called as cache memory. Moreover, this cache memory is is acting as a temporary memory and fastest clearance memory also. Suppose I am considering a scenario that you are logging into any kind of website. Suppose you are going to log into some Flipkart or any kind of websites like that. First time when you access that website or when you visit that website, then the time taken to access or display that particular website will be quite higher. The system will load and the screen will display after few seconds only. Okay, so after just you have visited and seen a certain kind of transactions or any kind of interactions with that page, after that you are closing that page, then after 1 hour or 1 day, you are going to access the same Flipkart or Amazon page which you accessed previously. Now it will definitely have a faster access. That is, when you type flipkart.com or amazon.in, then when you compare the time taken to visit that website now and the previously visited time, then definitely the second access of that particular page is quite faster than you previously accessed time of that page. So this is because of the presence of cache memory only. Okay, so this topic mainly clears the doubts regarding that accessing of data in the web page or in your own system, that is from your hard disk. So cache hit. So if the processor finds that the memory location in the cache, a cache hit is occurred. Okay, suppose you are searching for a memory location or a file which is present in a particular memory location, then whenever the system or the processor finds that memory location you are searching, then it is considered as cache hit. That is you are hitting that particular searched memory location. So it is considered as cache hit. whereas catch miss. However, if the processor does not find the memory location in the cache memory, okay, whenever there is a scenario happening when the processor is randomly checking a particular type of memory location which you are in search of, then it can't able to find that particular page that you are going to search in a reputed period of time, then it is considered as you have missed the access to that page for a particular period of time. So it is considered as catch miss. Okay, so in the catch of catch hit, in the case of catch hit, the processor immediately reads or writes the particular data into the catch line. Okay, so whenever there is a data you are searching is there in the cache and it is readily accessed by the processor, then catch hit occurs. Then you can read the data or write the data or perform any kind of operations with that particular data or file you are searching for. Okay, so this is the main concept of catch hit and catch miss. So by means of catch hit and catch miss, we can able to calculate the performance or the access time of the particular file. Okay, so that is we are going to discuss in the next slide. Okay, so catch performance. Okay, catch performance, that is the performance of the cache memory. Okay, so two measures that categorize the performance of the catch are hit ratio and effective access time. Okay, hit ratio and effective access time plays a very important role in calculating the performance of the cache memory. Okay, first we will see the hit ratio. Why they are saying it as the hit ratio means it calculates the ratio of access of particular data with the number of times you are hitting that particular data in the memory location. Okay, so the formula for hit ratio is here it goes. Num, so that is number of times referenced word are in the cache. So number of times you are searching. So suppose when you are searching a particular memory location or a particular data 5 times. Okay, so after that only you are going to access that particular data in the 6th time. Okay, so 5 times you have continuously tried to access that particular word or file in that particular memory location. So that number will be placed in the numerator. Okay, so number of times the referenced word are in the cache memory. So in the denominator we are having total number of memory accesses. Okay, so how many times you are accessing that particular memory you are searching, that comes in this hit ratio. So when you are computing the number of times referenced word in the cache to the total number of memory accesses that are there in the current operation, then you will get a number which clearly shows the hit ratio of your particular cache memory. Okay, so next one is effective access time. Okay, so effective access time, here the formula says that this hash symbol represents total number. Okay, so total number of hits, so total number of hits into time per hit. Okay, so time per hit plus total number of misses into time per miss, total divided by total number of memory accesses. So in the hit ratio also and in the effective access time also, you are having the denominator as same, that is total number of access time and the here also there is total number of access time. Based upon the total number of memory accesses only we can able to predict the hit ratio and also the effective time of particular cache memory access. Okay, so these are all the very important things that you have to concentrate when you are going for a gate related questions. Okay, so for the second formula, that is effective access time, I will say certain assumptions or scenario. Just think of it. Suppose I am saying that you have to access a particular website. Consider that website as flipkart.com. Okay, so you are going to access a website called Flipkart. So you have to calculate the effective access time. That is the task I am giving to you. So you will what you will do, you will search for that website and try to access that website in the web page, right? So when you are insisted to calculate the effective access time, then the scenario will be like this. Suppose you are accessing for the website at the first time, so you can't able to access. So first time the accessing is failed. So second time you are again accessing that page, so you have access to that page now. So one time you missed the access of that page, and the second time you have hit the access of that page. Okay, so total number of hits is equal to 2. So total time, total amount of time you have spent to hit that particular page, right? So first time it has failed, so number one. So second time you have hit, so you have reached that page and accessed that page, so total number of hits is equal to 2. So likewise, number of misses, so first time you missed the access of that page, and the second time you have access to that page, that is hit that page, so total number of misses is 1. Okay, one time you missed, so the second time you accessed, so you are substituting that value and compute the number of hits into time per hit plus number of misses into time per miss. Okay, time per hit and time per miss are the total time required to hit that page. Suppose whenever when you are accessing the tried to access that page for the first time, it takes 1 minute, and again it failed, and the second time it takes 1 minute, but you have hit that page, so then total number of time per hit is 1 minute. So total time per misses is 1 minute. Okay, so these are all the constraints you have to consider. Okay, so whenever you are substituting that particular probabilities in this scenario, then you will get the effective access time. Okay, these are all the basics. So next we will move on to the gate related questions for a discussion. So now we will just move on to the RAM and DRAM, that is random access memory and dynamic random access memory, and this question also have its own way into the decoder also. Okay, so decoder, so decoder we have already discussed in the last session. So it decodes the particular information that is given as input to that decoder. Yes, so then here the question I will read out the question, just listen to that, then we will have a discussion. Okay, so the question goes like this: a RAM chip has a capacity of 1024, that is 1024 words of 8 bits each. Okay, so 1024 words, consider these words, bits and bytes indications. So we have to consider whether it is a word or bit or byte, and then only you can able to predict the correct answer. Okay, a RAM chip has a capacity of 1024 words of 8 bits each. Okay, 8 bits equal to 1 byte, we already know. So we are dividing that 1024 words into 8 bits of segregation. That is, they have indicated like this: 1k into 8. Okay, 1k into 8 indication. The number of 2x4 decoders with enabled line needed to construct 16k into 16 RAM from 1k into 8 RAM is. So this is the question. So what they are saying is, you are going to construct a RAM chip. Okay, a RAM chip has a capacity 1024 into 8, that is 1k into 8 capacity of word holding memory. Okay, so next, the number of decoders, that is the decoder is 2 input and 4 output decoder. Okay, whenever you are giving as 2 input, it will decode that particular inputs into 4 different outputs. Okay, so so the number of decoders with the enabled line, so enabled line needed to construct, that is they are asking total number of decoders needed to construct 16k into 16 RAM. Okay, you are having a RAM of 1k into 8. Okay, I have given you a RAM, okay, just hold this RAM. Okay, this RAM capacity is 1K into 8 RAM. Okay, that is, it can hold 1024 words. Each word is segregated into 8 bits. Okay, so I have given this RAM chip to you. Okay, you are holding that RAM chip in your hand. Just assume. So I am going to give you a task. What is the task? The I ask you to analyze how many number of decoders you will be needed to construct 16K into 16 RAM. Okay, so you are having 1K into 8 RAM chip. Okay, 1K into 8 RAM capacity chip you are having. I am going to say you that you need to construct a decoder. Okay, so construct a RAM of 16K into 16 RAM. Okay, so with the help of 1K into 8 RAM, okay, with the help of 1K into 8 RAM, you are going to design or construct 16K into 8 RAM. Okay, with this, you are going to construct 16K into 16 RAM. So how many number of decoders you will be in need of? That is the question. Okay, how many decoders that is you are in need of to construct 16K into 16 RAM? The question is explained clearly. Okay, so here they have given the options A 4, B 5, C 6 and D 7. Okay, so first we will see what are all the aspects in this. Okay, so decoder. Okay, decoder is a combinational circuit logic. Yes, it is a combinational circuit logic that has n input lines and maximum of 2 power n output lines. So consider this diagram. The cursor I am moving in the right side. So consider this diagram. In this diagram, it is clearly saying that decoder, diagrammatic representation of the decoder. It is 2 by 4. We are giving two inputs, A and B, and we are getting output as D0, D1, D2, D3. So two inputs and four output decoder. Okay, so in this, we are considering highest priority decoder as D3 and lowest priority decoder as D0. Okay, so these are all the outputs from the decoder, 2 by 4. Okay, so input is 2 and output is 2 power 2, that is 4. Okay, that is only they have given in the first bullet. So decoder is a circuit or combinational circuit logic that has n input lines and maximum 2 power n output lines. That is 2 in this diagram, 2 input lines and 2 power 2, that is 4 output lines. Okay, so now we will move on to the given data. Okay, so RAM chip size. What is the RAM chip size they have given? 1K into 8. Okay, that is, it can hold 1024 words of data. Each will be segregated as 8 bits. Okay, each word will be segregated as 8 bits. Okay, so this is the RAM chip size. Okay, so next, we have to construct a RAM. Okay, we have to construct a RAM which is of capacity 16K into 16. We are having 1K into 8 capacity RAM chip in our hand. So we with the help of that, we are going to construct a RAM chip. What is the capacity of our constructing RAM chip? 16K into 16. Okay, so 16K into 16 RAM. That is, how can you represent this? 1024 into 16. Okay, so 1024 into 16. So how many answer you are getting? So that answer gives the capacity of words you are going to construct. So 1024 is the given word capacity, but you are going to construct 16 into 1024 capacity word RAM chip. So given RAM chip is in your hand, you are having 8 bit segregation of 1024 RAM chip. Now you are going to construct 16. Okay, so 2 8 bits, that is 16 bit capacity of 16K RAM you are going to construct. Before we are moving on to the data, we just have a look into RAM chip. Okay, so on the left hand side, I have given the diagram for a RAM chip. So I have given 128 into 8 RAM chip. Okay, so 128 word size into 8 bit segregation RAM chip is the given RAM chip. So that is there in the diagram. Okay, so what are all the input lines we are having? Chip select 1, chip select 2, CS1 and CS2. Okay, they are having two different chip selection for higher order bit and lower order bit. Okay, higher order input and lower order input. Okay, so next read and write operations, RD and WR. So these are all read and write operation pins. Okay, so seven bit address, that is AD0 to AD7. Okay, so AD0, AD1, AD2, AD3, likewise it goes on to AD7. So seven bit input address lines you are having. Okay, so with that help of these chips and these pins, we are going to have a 8-bit data bus. Okay, so the output we are having 8-bit data bus. The output will be transferred to the next device or in the certain memory location by means of 8-bit data bus wire. Okay, these are all the given data. So we will move on to the solution of this given problem in the next slide. Okay, so what will be the solution? So consider this number of chips required, right? Number of chips required is 16K into 16. Okay, so 16K into 16 we are going to design with the help of 1K into 8. Okay, so then we have to find the ratio. Ratio, whenever we are finding the ratio, then we can get the number of chips required in addition. Okay, so 16K into 16 divided by 1K into 8. Then we will get the answer as 16 into 2. Okay, so what does it indicate? 16 chips vertically with each having 2 chips horizontally. So just assume 16 RAM chips are aligned vertically. Okay, vertically in 90 degree we are aligning that particular chips. 16 different chips vertically, and each of them is having 2 chips horizontal. Okay, each chip is having 2 chips as horizontal alignment, as adjacent to it. So to select one chip out of 16, so we are having 2 chips horizontal, so we are going to select one chip out of that 16 vertical chips. Okay, 16 vertical chips out of this, we are going to select one chip by means of this chip select pin CS1 and CS2. So 16 out of 16, we are going to select one chip. So we are in need of 4 into 16 decoder. Okay, we are in need of 4 into 16 decoder. Okay, so in the diagram, we are having 2 into 4 decoder. Right, 2 into 4, so 2 input and 4 output. So 2 is the input and 2 power 2 is the output. So likewise here 4 is the input and what is there? So 16 is the output. 4 into 4, so 16 is the output. So input is 2, that is n is equal to 4. Sorry, input is 4. So 4 pins are there as input. So 4 is the representation of n. So in the output, we will be having 2 power n, right? That is 2 power 4. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So we are getting 16 decoder. So input is 4 and output is 16 decoder. So available decoder is 2 by 4 decoder only we are having. Yes. So in this question itself, they have given, we are having 2 by 4, 2 into 4 decoder we are having. So by using 2 into 4 decoder, we are going to construct 4 into 16 decoder. So hence, we are in need of 4 plus 1 extra one decoder. So 5 decoders are we are in need of. So the answer will be 5. Okay, so A, B, C and D they have given. So out of which the correct answer is 5. So the number of 2x4 decoders with enable lines, that is chip selection lines, needed to construct 16K into 16 RAM is 5. So the answer is 5. So first time you are listening to these kind of questions, right? So it will be quite problematic when you are consuming. So repeatedly, whenever we are seeing these kind of questions for discussion, you will be clear with the understanding capability. Okay, so next we will move on to a slightly basic question. So an instruction is decoded when it is kept inside. The options are program counter, instruction register, accumulator, arithmetic logic unit, ALU. So the instruction is decoded when it is kept inside. So what they are asking, when the instructions are decoded, whether it is in program counter, so when it is in instruction register, when it is in accumulator, or when it is in ALU. Any guesses? Guys, any guesses? If you have any guesses, you can choose the option. We will see the answer in the next slide. Any guesses? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me. Tell me the answer. Right or wrong, it is not a matter. Just tell me the answer. The question itself, there is an answer. It is the clue. An instruction
register.
Hey. So the option is what you are saving. Saying
instruction
register B. So let us see what is the answer. So the answer is right. Very good. So the solution is instruction register. So the instruction register, we are always representing it as IR, right? Instruction register, or it can also be said as current instruction register, CIR. Both are same. So instruction register or current instruction registers, IR or CIR, is a part of CPU's control unit only. It can hold the currently being executed instruction or currently being executed or decoded instruction. So instruction, the main task of instruction register is it can hold the currently being executed instruction or decoded instruction. So the answer is very correct. So your answer is instruction decoder. So these kind of questions are also being asked in gate related questions. So you have to keenly have an idea about what is instruction register, what is program counter, what is accumulator, what is the use of arithmetic and logical unit. So these are all you should be very clear about that. Then only you can able to crack these kind of very easy questions that are occasionally being displayed in gate related sessions or gate related questions. Okay, so it is an extra advantage. Okay, when you are very clear in your topic, means you will definitely crack these kind of questions. Okay, so next question. So consider a memory system that takes 25 ns means a nanoseconds. So 25 nanoseconds to service the access of a single 64-bit word. Okay, so we're going to consider a memory system that, just assume you are considering a memory system that can take 25 nanoseconds to access a particular 64-bit data. Okay, you have, if you want to access 64-bit data, then you have to spend 25 nanoseconds for accessing that. So the bandwidth of processor and memory, okay, the bandwidth between the processor and memory interface will be how many megabytes per second? The question is very clear. So what is the bandwidth of interfacing processor, that is CPU and memory? Okay, in terms of, you have to say the answer in terms of megabytes per second, that is MB per second, MBPS. Okay, so MBPS. So you will be using SIM cards, right? So each SIM will be Airtel or Aircel or Jio. So each SIM, when you are using or accessing a website, then it will be the speed of that particular accessing capability is mainly indicated by means of how many Mbps. So 10 Mbps per second. So likewise, only they are measuring that. So likewise, they are asking, you are going to access a particular 64-bit word in 25 seconds. Then what is the bandwidth between processor, CPU, and memory? Okay, you are going to represent that bandwidth by means of Mbps. Okay, so the answer is, the options are 320, 160, 640, and 180. Okay, so just we will move on to the next slide so that you will be clear with the description. So here it goes. So 1 byte is equal to 16 bit. We already know 16 bits equal to 1 byte. 8 bits equal to 1 byte. Okay, so 64 bits represent 8 bytes. So 8 bytes of data can be accessed in 25 seconds, right? So here 8 bytes of data. Okay, 8 8s are 64. So 64 word size of data can be accessed in 25 seconds. We can say it as 8 bytes of data can be accessed in 25 nanoseconds. So for 1 second, in 1 second, the number of bytes accessed is 8 by 24 into 10 power 9 bytes. Okay, we are converting that into megabytes, Mbps. So we are multiplicating the particular value by 10 power 9 bytes. So we are getting the answer 320 Mbps. So the answer is 320 Mbps per second. That is Mbps per second. So the bandwidth required for accessing processor and memory interface will be 320 Mbps. Okay, that is the answer. So quickly we'll move on to next question. Assume an L1 cache. Okay, so the L1, L2 are the cache names. Okay, so L1 cache with a hit rate of 70%. Okay, hit rate means the rate at which a particular data is accessed or particular memory location is accessed in the cache memory. So that we can say it as hit rate. So similarly, we are having miss rate. Miss rate is how many times or how many rate at which we are missing that particular access of data. That is considered as catch miss rate. Okay, it can be said as catch miss rate or miss rate. Okay, so we are assuming that L1 catch is having a hit rate of 70%, and L2 is the catch memory with miss rate of 10%. Okay, hit rate is 70%, miss rate is 10% for L1 and L2 catch. If there are 1,000 memory accesses initiated by CPU, CPU is initiating 1,000 memory accesses. It can able to access 1,000 memories, memory locations. Okay, so accessing time. So then the number of access that will find a hit in L2 catch. So the question is very simple. So L1 and L2 catch are the two types of catch we are having. The hit rate of L1 catch is 70%. The miss rate of L2 catch is 10%. So L1 is equal to 70% hit rate. L2 is equal to 10% miss rate. So what they are asking, 1,000 memory accesses is granted. Okay, you can access 1,000 memory access in CPU. Okay, so then the number of accesses that will find a hit in L2. So they have only given miss rate of L2. Miss rate of L2 is 10% only, but they are asking how many accesses for hit rate. That is asking for hit rate for accessing 1,000 memory accesses. So these are all the options they have given: 270A. So B option is 320, C option is 480, and D option is 620. Okay, so I am repeating or simplifying your theme of this question. L1 catch hit rate is 70%. They have not given miss rate. L2 catch miss rate is 10%. We are going to find out hit rate of L2. Okay, the question is simple. So what is the hit rate of L2? Okay, that is we are representing it in numerical values. Okay, so the solution, number of accesses that will find a hit in L2 catch. Okay, so number of accesses that will find, that is L2 catch memory's hit rate is equal to miss rate of L1 into hit rate of L2, total divided by number of memory accesses. Okay, this is the very important calculation or formula you have to clearly memorize. So that is miss rate of L1 into hit rate of L2, total divided by number of memory accesses. So whenever you are computing this, then you will get the answer. So 30% is the miss rate of L1. So 30%, that is hit rate they have given. Hit rate is 70, means then miss rate will be 70 minus 100, that is 100 minus 70, that is 30%. That is the basic logic. So 30% is the miss rate of L1 into 1000 instructions, okay, into 1000 instructions plus 90% of 1000 instructions, okay, into 90% of 1000 instructions, total divided by what they have given, total number of memory accesses. So total number of memory accesses is 1000. Just a minute. Hello. Okay, so 30% of 1000 instructions plus 90% into 1000 instructions, total divided by total number of memory accesses, that is 1000. Okay, whenever we are computing this, we will get the answer as 27,000. Okay, so that is 270,000 divided by 1000. So we will be getting the answer as 270. Okay, so 270 is the given answer. So the answer is A, 270. Okay, so next we will move on to. So next we'll move on to next question. So this question is quite complex, I think. So just listen to this question. A cache memory has a hit rate of 95%. Okay, you are having, this is a improvisation of the previous question that we have seen, L1 and L2 cache memory in the last fourth question, right? So it is a quiet improvisation of the previous question. So what they have given, just listen to the question, I will read out clearly. Cache has a hit rate of 95% and the hit time is 10 nanosecond. Okay, cache memory's hit rate is 95%, so the miss rate will be 5%. Okay, so basic analysis only. Then the hit time is 10 nanoseconds. The time required to access that particular page or access particular data is 10 nanoseconds. Okay, the cache block size is 32 bytes. Okay, the block size of cache is 32 bytes. That is, the cache memory has the capacity of 32 bytes holding blocks. Okay, so next, the word length of the processor is 16 bits. Okay, many kind of data are given in this. So hit rate is 95%, hit time is 10 nanoseconds, cache block size is 32 bytes, and word length is 16 bits. Okay, 16 bit word length. Okay, based upon this word length only, you can able to place that particular word size in the cache block. Okay, so these are all the data given. So what they are asking, during a cache miss, it takes x nanoseconds to fetch the first word of the block. So whenever there is a miss in the catch memory, okay, miss rate, whenever there is a catch miss occurs, it the catch miss is assumed as x nanoseconds. Okay, we don't know how much nanoseconds it takes to miss. Okay, so they are considering it as x. Let us assume the catch miss time is x nanoseconds. Okay, so and 5 nanoseconds for fetching each subsequent words. So whenever there is a word next instruction, likewise it is coming frequently, means subsequently they are coming. So it spends 5 nanoseconds for fetching next instruction. So for fetching operation itself, they are the cache memory is taking 5 nanoseconds. Okay, suppose I am fetching one value. So now I am accessing a particular value. It takes x number of seconds. So next instruction is to be fetched in the after the completion of the current instruction, right? So for that, it takes 5 nanoseconds to bring that particular word into my location. So after that, it takes again 5 nanoseconds for again inputting that particular instruction or fetching that instruction into the current. Likewise, it is moving on. So what is they are asking? The average memory access time is 15 nanoseconds. Then the value of x is what? So x means number of nanoseconds to fetch first word of the block. So how many, the question is simple. So how many number of seconds, that is nanoseconds, is needed for fetching first instruction into the catch block? Okay, we are having 32 byte size catch block. Okay, so for first instruction to be fetched into that particular, or bringing that first instruction into the catch block, how much nanosecond is needed? That is the question. Okay, so whenever you are analyzing these kind of questions, there will be some kind of extra data that will be added as a spicy thing into the particular question for deviating your or confusing your data inputs. Okay, so what are all they given? Hit rate 95%, hit time 10 nanoseconds, block size 32 bytes, word length 16 bits, x is the number of seconds we are going to compute. So 5 nanoseconds is the total number of time taken for inputting the next instruction, subsequent instructions. So average access time, average memory access time, we are representing it as AMAT, so or MAT. So memory access time is 15 nanoseconds. So that much of data they have given. So out of which we are in need of a certain type of data only. So they are adding up certain type of data in certain questions to confuse you or deviate you from correctly answering the question. So whenever you are getting these kind of questions, you should be clear with what kind of data you are definitely in need of. So the data which you need, just keep it, and the extra data you are not in need of, just skip the data. Okay, so the answers options are given as 20, 32, 25 and 64. We will see the discussion first and then we will see the answer. So AMAT, average memory access time. So this is the formula. So for based upon catch hit and catch miss and catch hit rate and miss rate, miss penalty, hit ratio, miss ratio, these are all the basics that will be there in catch type of gate questions. So out of which you have to you have to compute the given specifications. So AMAT, average memory access time, is equal to hit time of L1 catch. Okay, they have given only one type of catch block, right? So we are considering it as L1 block. L1 is the catch name. Okay, for our convenience, we are naming it as L1. So hit time of L1, that is hit time of catch, plus miss rate of L1 catch into miss penalty of L1 catch. Okay, so this miss penalty is computed as time to fetch the block from memory. Okay, so time to fetch the block from memory, it is considered as miss penalty. Okay, suppose you have missed that particular data, then you have to compensate that particular data by bringing that particular data into the memory location. So that is called as miss penalty. So penalty is like a fine. So we have missed that particular data, we have missed the access to that particular data, so we will be putting it as penalty. Okay, so miss penalty of that particular catch is equal to time to fetch that particular block from memory. Okay, that block will be there in memory, so we have to bring that block from the memory and we have to fetch that into catch memory block. So what amount of time you are spending for bringing that block from the memory, that time is considered as miss penalty time. So the third one, total number of words in the block is 32. So in the question itself, they have given 32 bytes of data is there in the cache block. So 32 by 2 is equal to 16 words. We are each word we is split up into 2 bytes. Okay, so 16 into 16, so 16 words are there in the block. Okay, the time to fetch the block from memory. So the time to fetch the block from memory here, so the time to fetch is miss penalty. We have given miss penalty is equal to time to fetch the block from memory. So miss penalty is equal to first word, okay, the first word into x nanoseconds, okay, wow. So plus 15 into 5. So we are putting it from the given data. So the average memory access time is considered as 15 nanoseconds. So that is they have given in the question itself, the average memory access time is 15 nanoseconds. So with that help of these formulas, we can able to find out the number of words. So 15 is equal to 10 plus 0.05 star miss penalty. Okay, so 10 plus 0.05 into x plus 75. So whenever we are simplifying that, we will get 25 nanoseconds. Okay, just to work out this kind of problems, so then only we can able to understand or analyze these kind of scenarios. So the answer is 25 nanoseconds. So then the value of x is 25 nanoseconds means what we are implying. So it takes 25 nanoseconds to fetch the first word of the block. Okay, so to bring the first word into the catch block memory, we are in need of 25 nanoseconds. Okay, so that is the 25 nanoseconds is the our answer. Okay, so these are all the simplifications they have made. Again, I have clearly indicated this. So the last question we are in discussion in this session is, consider a direct mapped cache with a 64 block. That is, our cache memory is 64 block size. So 64 blocks. It is having 64 blocks, and the block size of 16 bytes. Okay, 64 blocks and 16 bytes of data it can accommodate. To what block number does the byte address 1204, that is 1206, map into? So 64 blocks are there, and each block size is 16 bytes. Okay, so 16 into 64 you have to compute, so that number of addresses it can hold. Okay, so now what they are asking means, for holding it can hold n number of addresses, right? So then 1206th address byte is mapped into which block? So that is the given question they have asked. Okay, so they have also given the options for that. First option is it does not map. So what does it indicate? Suppose the block size exceeds the particular value, means then the 1206 will not be mapped into the our given criteria or given concept they have mentioned in the given data. So second option is 6 and third option is 11 and fourth option is 54. So the first option is only different, does not map. So it is like beyond the out of box scenario. Okay, so just the given data is very simple. So we are going to consider a catch block. Let us assume that catch block has L1. So L1 catch memory, you can name it as anything, but for our reference, we are naming it as a catch memory as L1 and L2 only we will be naming. So we are having L1 as a catch memory. So in that cache memory, there are 64 blocks and each block size is 16 bytes. So total number of total number of bytes allocated is 64 into 16, just you can compute. So what they are asking, to which data 206th address byte is or it will be mapped. Okay, so that is the question they have asked. So the solution is very simple. So the block size is 16 bytes, right? The block size is 16. So the memory block number, okay, so there are many types of memory blocks we have given in the that they have given in the question itself. So the memory, how can you compute that memory block number? So memory block number is equal to that byte address divided by block size. Okay, total block size, how much block size. So they have given the block size as 16. So we are going to compute the mapping address of 1206th address, right? So we are dividing that 1206 divided by 16. So we will be getting a particular answer. So let us say it will come around 75. Okay, so the given byte address, that is 1206, is a part of that particular 75th block, right? So there will be decimal points also when you are computing, just eliminate it or round it off. Okay, so it will come around, I think, 75. So it will be a part of 75th block, we can say, right? So 1000, then I can say that 1206 address will be mapped onto something around 75th block of my cache memory. Okay, so first part is over. We have computed or located a particular block number. Okay, that is 75. So now we have to compute the cache blocks block number. Okay, that is the question they have asked. So we already know the formula for computing the block, that is cache block number, is memory block number modulo division of number of blocks that are there in the cache. Okay, so we have seen in the first part of our solution as 75th block, in and around 75th block it will be mapped. Okay, approximately. So we will consider that approximate value itself. So 75 modulo 16, like that 16, when you are computing 75 modulo 15, there will be 11 or 12 around answer you will be coming. Yes, 11 or 12. So just consider the options they have given. First option is does not map. Second option is 6. Third option is 11. And fourth option is 54. So the also consider in these kind of questions, just to have a approximate computation. Okay, they have not asking for accurate type of answers in this type of questions. So whenever you are reading these kind of questions, you can make an approximate value, then it will be coming around the options they have given. Suppose in this question we have discussed that the 75 modulus of something 16, it will be coming around 11, 12 or 13, right? So the answer in this answer, we are having the option as 11. So whenever you are getting 11, 12, 13, like kind such kind of answers, you just match up that particular answer to the given data. Okay, so that you will not consume so much of time in computing accurate values. So the better option is approximation of computation in this kind of scenario or in this kind of questions. Okay, so the answer will be 11. Okay. So we have so far discussed what are all the cache memory and topics related to cache block and cache hit, cache miss, and hit rate, miss rate, hit ratio, miss ratio. Then how can we compute the block size of that particular memory and RAM chip memory calculations. So these are all the important type of questions they will be asking. Okay, so just go through these kind of questions and refer the questions which are resembling these kind of scenarios in the net resources, that is web resources, and have an idea in these kind of cache performance considerations related kind of gate questions. Okay, so hope you will be understanding these kind of scenarios and these kind of questions, answering these kind of questions. So with this we will end up this session. So we will see another kind of performance consideration topics in the next session of our GATE class. Okay, so thank you for listening. Thank you for considering this in your session. Okay. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, pa. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, pa. So just the session is over. You can leave. Thank you.